Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Wednesday, March 23rd, 2011. In the pre-market this morning at 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast, we've got stock index futures slightly above fair value, but we do have commodities up across the board, so that should be helpful for the TSX at 9:30 this morning. Now, the global markets still look pretty hungover after the big down move that we had. The Japanese market has come up into the open gap. We've spent 2 days there now. Last night, the Nikkei in Japan closed lower on the day. It actually traded through the previous day's low, but did not close there. So we are still working with that open gap resistance for the Japanese market. Move over to Australia. We haven't gotten high enough to test the open gap just yet. For the last 2 days, we've traded up to the upper channel line but have not closed above it, so we're still on a sell signal in Australia. In Germany, we're on our third day now of trying to break through the top of the open gap and have not been able to do so. You can see two bars there where we tried to break through. Today, the DAX is up slightly. It was down 35 points yesterday. Today, I believe it's up about 15 points. So once again, we have not been able to break through the top of that open gap. Looking at the U.S. market, we've spent the last 2 days trying to break through 1,300 on the S&P 500 have not been able to do so. What we're seeing in the futures in the pre-market this morning still does not get us up over 1,300. So we're watching the 1,300 level on the S&P 500 very closely. Now, 1,300 is a big round number, which provides psychological resistance. It is also the place where the 50-day moving average intersects right now, and so that's providing resistance. So we found support at the 100-day moving average and resistance at the 50-day moving average, and that's the playing field where we've been playing in since the market started to break down. So if we can break out above the 50-day moving average, the assumption would be that we could go back up and retest the recent high. Moving over, looking at the daily charts for the major indexes that we follow, the VIX had a very quiet day yesterday, probably the quietest day it's had in quite a while now, and I'm not sure what that tells us, but certainly the market took a breather yesterday. We're still on a sell signal for the VIX, which should be supportive for higher stock prices if we can get the S&P 500 over 1,300. Looking at the TSX, we're stuck at 14,000 right now. If we can move up, our next target is 1,462, and then 14,375 would be our next target above that. Taking a look at the energy sector, we're stuck at 360. 375 is our next target to the upside if we can break away from this area of resistance. Taking a look at financial services, we're still on a buy signal. Yesterday, we've been hanging around just below resistance at 200. Hopefully, we can break out above that and take the financial services index to newer highs. Now, the TSX Gold Index is now back on a buy signal. Looks like the pros are coming back to take control. We're stuck here at 390.63. A breakout above that should take us up two lines to retest the highs from 2 weeks ago. Barrick's not participating right now. We are seeing money flow back into Agnico Eagle and a lot more money flow back into Kinross. Now, silver stocks are still doing well. I'd rather be chasing silver stocks than gold stocks. The materials sector, nothing going on there yesterday. Stuck up here at resistance at the intersection of the 50 and 100-day moving averages. Looking at copper stocks, nothing going on with copper stocks this week. Fertilizer stocks, nothing going on here. Uranium stocks stuck at the bottom of the open gap. We saw Denison Mines come up to the top of the open gap and stop. We need to close above 287 to give us a buy signal on Wednesday. Take a look at the Venture Exchange. We're on a buy signal. The Venture 30 is on a buy signal. The bonds are still on a buy signal. No change there. No change for the Canadian dollar. No change for the U.S. dollar. Looking at commodities, we saw basically gains across the board yesterday. Uranium was up another buck. We saw coal move higher yesterday. We saw crude oil move higher and natural gas. Looking at the metals, nothing going on with copper. We're still on a buy signal. Gold moved higher yesterday, and we saw silver move higher as well. Looking at our roadmap for Wednesday's trading activity, we're at the top of the panic zones. We've worked our way through two early warning signals without any downward pressure. We need to break out above 14,062. That would take us up to 14,218 as our next target for Wednesday if we can do that. On the downside, we hope to find resistance at the 1,300 level, which is where our flypaper, the bottom of our flypaper channel is. That takes us back into an open gap. So we're going to remain bullish as long as we continue to trade above the 13,800 level. Our first sign of weakness on Wednesday is going to be an intraday sell signal with an hourly close below 13,990. Okay, that's all for Wednesday morning, folks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again on Thursday morning.